Well, the inspiration for my new book, My China, really came about, I guess, by my own thoughts and feelings as an adult. I'm an Australian-born Chinese person. In the last 3 years, I've been to China about 12 times for business, and it just sort of struck me, you know, it'd be wonderful to document all of my thoughts and feelings and impressions on this amazing, complex, diverse country. And that's precisely what we did. We travelled through 10 different provinces and cities across China, and we went into Tibet. And we not only, you know, recorded a lot of the food culture that you find all over China and Tibet, especially the regional cuisine of China, which is totally amazing, complex and interesting. I also wanted to record the amazing sort of characters that I met along the way, like Mrs. Zhu, the 65-year-old who lives in Hangzhou, who beat me at an arm wrestle because of her beautiful green tea. I met some amazing people in Tibet, for example, the lovely street sellers who made, you know, sold me all the beautiful Tibetan beads, a wonderful Tibetan guide who took us through the Potala Palace and knew so much about Buddhism that, you know, it was so inspiring to be with him. There's about 80 new recipes in the book, all of which are very home-style Chinese cuisine. One of the great dishes was from my family village in deepest, darkest rural China, southern China, stir-fried black beans with ginger. We intended to do this major photo shoot that day in the village, so we bought all the props at the local market, the fresh food, the fruit and vegetables, and I bought these lovely big sort of golden pumpkins, you know, intending them to be props. You know, never did I ever think before, have I ever tasted pumpkin with, you know, in a Chinese fashion. I'm cooking there at the village, and one of the newfound relatives sort of grabs the pumpkin off me and then slices it into a million pieces and then tells me to stir fry it in the wok with some peanut oil and ginger and black beans. And there we have it, this magnificent local dish, pumpkin with black bean and ginger. So now, of course, I serve it in my restaurant in Sydney. Many stories like that where I picked up recipes along the way, incredibly spontaneous and dynamic sort of feel to the whole place. Another great experience we had, which was just, you could not have planned this experience in a million years. We're driving down the mountain from Yam Droxo Lake, which is 4,500 metres above sea level. We're driving 2 hours down the mountain back to Lhasa, so we're in Tibet. And we had all of this, we had a whole lot of fresh food in the car because we were intending to do a photo shoot up at Yam Droxo Lake, you know, by the lake in the middle of the Tibetan Plateau. That day it was too cold and windy to do such a thing, so we canned the idea. We're driving down the mountain and then the bus breaks down. We're in the middle of nowhere, we're in the Tibetan Plateau. My guy jumps out of the car and sort of fixes up everything as he did, and he's like, don't worry, it's just the brake fluids, the brakes don't work. And we're like, great, you know, the brakes don't work. So we had to sit there, we had to stay where we were for several hours, and we just happened to pull up outside this Tibetan village, which was in the middle of nowhere. So my guide went inside, and the next minute, the lady who owned the home and her children came running out to the car. They had agreed to allow us to go inside and do this incredible photo shoot, me cooking on her stove and so on. We offered them a little bit of money. They were just over the moon. So all the kids helped me take the fresh food inside. We were in the most beautiful setting. If you can imagine the most rustic, colourful Tibetan-style home in the middle of the mountains. Beautiful prayer beads hanging everywhere, richly painted walls decorated with sort of Tibetan symbols. The mother was there, the children, the grandmother, so, you know, three generations of family living in this one little house, all dressed in Tibetan, you know, typical Tibetan costume, beautiful rich fabrics, jewelries, earrings, everything. And we're doing this incredible photo shoot there. That was truly memorable. But that was really, that experience really reflected the sort of spirit of the whole trip. And I really hope that sort of spirit and the essence of the trip, you know, comes out through the book, through the photographs, through the writing. An extremely personal account of my travels through China and Tibet, which I just loved.